See, in Wood's educational dispatch of 1854, just occurred what was that westernization of education because of universities were opened in 1857 in Kolkata, Bombay and Madras. Okay. Now, this completed railway telegraph postal system opened introduced in 1853 and establishment of public works department. Okay. An engineering college was established, an engineering college at Roorkee. Okay. And this plan to open on universities in Kolkata, Bombay and Madras in the model of universities of London. Okay. This Lord Dalhousie, this Lord Dalhousie only just planned, okay, that we have to open university in Kolkata, Bombay and Madras at the model of universities of London. And this universities were actually opened in 1857, okay. And second, Anglo-Burmese War, Santhal uprisings and Charter Act of 1853. See, Charter Act of 1853 occurred during Dalhousie. It is important, okay. Dalhousie, Charter Act of 1853. Now, let's come to another topic. This is Viceroy of India. Viceroys of India. And the first Viceroy of India was Lord Canning. Okay. And also Lord Canning was the last Governor General of India. Now, when Lord Canning came, this in 1857, Kolkata, Bombay and Madras universities were opened. Okay. Revolt of 1857. And he was the last Governor General appointed by the East India Company and the first Viceroy, passed the Government of India Act 1858. See, during Lord Dalhousie, Charter Act, during Lord Dalhousie, what happened? Charter Act of 1858 was passed, okay? 1853, during Lord Dalhousie, Charter Act of 1853 was passed. See, 1833 Charter Act was passed and it was who? It was William Bentinck, okay? William Bentinck. And just after 20 years, 1853, Charter Act was passed and here it was Dalhousie. Okay. Indian Penal Code 1859 passed. Income tax was introduced in 1858. Indigo rights in Bengal. And see, doctrine of lapse was introduced by Dalhousie, but it was withdrawn by whom? It was withdrawn by Canning. Okay. Lord Canning, we have to remember just this word, I, okay, I, we have to remember, Canning, I, see, this is tree, see, I for Indian Penal Code, I for Income Tax, I for Indigo Rights, Indian Council Act, Indian High Court, these all things happened during Canning, so we have to remember I, okay. Okay, Indian Council Act of 1861, Indian High Court Act 1861 was passed. Under this act, high courts were opened in 1865 and Bombay and Madras was founded in 1857. This Bombay and Madras was founded in 1857 during Canning. This finished, okay, Lord Canning. Now we come to Lord Elgin One. Just one thing we have to remember during Lord Elgin One is that Wahhabi movement was suppressed during Lord Elgin One. Okay, at the time of Sir John Lawrence, high courts were established at Kolkata, Bombay, and Madras in 1865. See, Indian High Court Act was passed in 1861 during whom Canning, but it was actually established in 1865 during whom? This during John Lawrence. Okay, remember. And the Punjab Tenancy Act was also passed during John Lawrence. Telegraph communication system started. Now Lord Mayo is very important. Lord Mayo is also very important. Lord Mayo, introduction of financial decentralization in India and made the first provincial settlement in 1870. He established the Department of Agriculture and Commerce, and during Lord Mayo, he organized the Statistical Survey of India in 1872. The first census was done in India, and he established Rajkot College in Kathiawar and Mayo College at Ajmer. The next viceroy is Sir John Lawrence. Okay, the next viceroy is Sir John Lawrence. So I think Sir John Lawrence, we have completed. Sir John Lawrence High Courts were established at Kolkata, Bombay and Madras in 1865. And this Lord Mayo is also completed in 1872. At his time, the first census was done in India. And he established, Lord Mayo established Rajkot College in Kathiawar and Mayo College at Ajmer. Okay, Mayo College at Ajmer, remember. And Viceroy. We have to remember one thing about Lord Mayo, that he was the only viceroy to be murdered in office by a convict in the Andaman in 1872. Lord Mayo was murdered in 1872. Okay, and state railways was introduced by Mayo. Lord Mayo introduced state railways. Now see Lord Northbrook. Here one thing is important. Lord Northbrook, in 1872, Kuka Rebellion occurred in Punjab, and it was led by Ram Singh. The question is asked that who led the Kuka movement, then it was Ram Singh responsible for Kuka Rebellion, and it occurred in Punjab, and famine in Bihar, 1876. Famine in Bihar was occurred in 1876. He resigned over Afghanistan question. Trial of Gagwards of Baroda, Northbrook. Okay, Lord Lytton is very unpopular viceroy of India. And see what was done by Lord Lytton, and opposite of that Lord Ripon did. Okay, Lord Ripon always did opposite of what Lord Lytton did. Okay, see Lord Lytton was most unpopular viceroy, okay? And he arranged the Grand Darbar in Delhi in 1877 when the country was suffering from severe famine. So isn't it critical about that when whole of the country was suffering from severe famine, and there this viceroy Lytton was engaging himself in celebrating the Grand Darbar in Delhi. Okay, and see how much money he invested in doing so much useless work. So Lord Lytton was really very cruel person. Okay, see, arranged the Grand Darbar in Delhi in 1877 when the country was suffering from severe famine. Passed the Bihar. In Bihar, famine occurred in 1876. Okay, and the country was suffering severe famine in 1876 or 77. Okay, and this Grand Darbar in Delhi was arranged in 1877. Okay, and he passed the Royal Title Act, and now in 1876, Queen Victoria was declared as Kesari Hind. This question is always asked, that Kesari Hind, who took the title of or who was declared as Kesari Hind, that this was Queen Victoria. Okay, Queen Victoria. And this he also passed Arms Act, infamous Vernacular Press Act 1878, and lowered the maximum age of ICS from 29 to 19 years. Second Anglo-Afghan War occurred, and famous commission under Starchi appointed by him in 1870, famine commission. He appointed Starchi as the head of famine commission, okay, in 1878. And in 1876, Deccan Agrarian Relief Act was passed during Lytton, okay. See, we have to remember that the Viceroy was Lord Lytton that the famous famine occurred, okay. So, the relief or anything done for the famine, of course, it would occur during Lord Lytton, okay. So, it is easy to learn that what happened during Lord Lytton, okay. Just remember that he passed Arms Act, Press Act and lowered the maximum age of ICS from 21 to 19 years, okay. And Queen Victoria was declared as Kesar-e-Hind, second Anglo-Afghan War, and the famine commission under Starchi was appointed by him in 1878. Also in 1876, Deccan Agrarian Relief Act was passed. Okay. Lord Ripon. Now let's read about Lord Ripon. So Lord Ripon was appointed by the Liberal Party under Gladstone, repealed the Vernacular Press Act in 1882. So finally he removed the Vernacular Press Act in 1882, and the first Factory Act came in 1881. He improved the labor condition in rural areas, okay. Local boards were set up in 1889. Madras Local Board was passed, and see, very much important line is this. This is that he was, that Lord Ripon was known as father of local self-government, okay. Who is known as local self-government? This is Lord Ripon, okay. Lord Ripon is known as local father of local self-government. And in 1881, first official census was that first official census in India in 1881 happened, okay. Famine Code was adopted in 1883, appointed Hunter Commission for Education Reforms in 1882. Ilwardville Controversy, this is important. Ilwardville Controversy, Ripon, remember, okay, that according to this, now the Indian judges had the power to inquire into the European cases, okay, and foundation of Punjab University. I think Punjab University was opened in 1882, okay. Now, next Viceroy is Lord Dufferin. I think the name Lord Dufferin, see, Dufferin. I think Lord Dufferin, most duffer Viceroy, I think, okay. Duffer. Lord Dufferin. See, during his time, Indian National Congress was formed in 1885. Okay, you know, Indian National Congress, whose first president was Yomesh Chandra Banerjee. And it was in Bombay. Okay, Bombay. So, this Dufferin called the Indian National Congress as microscopic minority, and I think he was fooled, so he called the Indian National Congress as microscopic unity. See, when this first meeting of Indian National Congress occurred in 1885, then only 72 delegates participated, okay, and in second it was increased to twice in number. So isn't it amazing one? Okay, and so it was wrong that he called this INC as microscopic unity, minority, okay. Now Bengal Tenancy Act in 1885, Bengal Tenancy Act was passed in 1885. And just in Lord at the time of Lord Dufferin, this little things happened. This Indian National Congress formation and Bengal Tenancy Act 1885, and just he called the Indian National Congress as microscopic minority. Now, next viceroy is Lansdowne, Lord Lansdowne. Okay, the Refectory Act of 1891 came, and Indian Council Act of 1892, Lord Lansdowne civil services were classified as imperial, provincial and subordinate services. In 1891, Age of Consent Act, under which marriage of girl below 12 years was prohibited. Appointment of Durand Commission. This is very much important, that appointment of Durand Commission in 1893 to define the line between British India and Afghanistan. Okay, this all thing happened during Lord Lansdowne. Now Lord Elgin too. Lord Elgin too, the Santhal uprisings, Munda uprisings, this both uprising occurred during Elgin too. The All Commission appointed after famine in Elgin, during the time of Elgin too. Assassination of two British officials by the Chapiker brothers in 1897. Lord Elgin too, okay, remember this happened during Lord Elgin too. These two British officials were assassinated, and this was very famous incident. We will study later on, okay. Chapiker brothers killed these two British officials, okay. And plague spread in Bombay during Lord Elgin too. Plague spread in Bombay during Lord Elgin too. Now see, Lord Curzon. Lord Curzon is very important person, and many things happened during Lord Curzon. This appointed a police commission in 1902 under Andrew Fraser. University commission appointed in 1902 under Thomas Reilly. Indian University Act passed in 1904. Famine commission under Macdonald. A new Department of Commerce and Industry was established. Partition of Bengal occurred on 16 October 1905. The risings of frontier tribes in 1897-98 led him to create the Northwestern Frontier Province. Northwestern Frontier Province was created during the Lord Curzon. Okay, he passed the Ancient Monument Protection Act 1904 to restore India's cultural heritage, and thus the Archaeological Survey of India was established during Lord Curzon. This is important. Archaeological Survey of India was established during whom period? So it was Lord Curzon, Viceroy. Okay. Indian Coinage and Paper Currency Act 1899 was passed and put India on a gold standard. Pusa Agriculture Institute in 1903 was set up during Lord Curzon. These all things is to be memorized. Okay. Lord Minto too. Lord Minto too, this few things was done during Lord Minto too. Lord Minto too, just Swadeshi movement. Okay. Surat split, the split in Congress between the moderates and the extremist. Indian Council Act 1909. This is also known as Morley Minto reforms, and foundation of Muslim League 1906. Newspaper Act 1908 was passed. Okay. Now Lord Harding too. He remained Viceroy from 1910 to 1916. This annulment of partition of Bengal 1911. Bomb was thrown. This is also very important incident which occurred during Lord Harding too. Okay. See, bomb was thrown at Harding near Chandni Chowk, but escaped unhurt. So someone threw bomb at Harding near Chandni Chowk in Delhi, but escaped unhurt, and he was saved. And this capital, Kolkata, transfer of capital from Kolkata to Delhi in 1911, and Darbar in Delhi, and coronation of George V in 1911. In 1912, Bihar and Orissa separated from Bengal and became a new state during whom period? That was Lord Harding too. Okay. In 1912, this Bihar and Orissa separated from Bengal and became a new state. Established Hindu Mahasabha by Madan Mohan Malviya during Lord Harding too. Gandhiji came back to India from South Africa in 1915. He also came in India in 1915 during Lord Harding too. Okay. Just remember, Lord Harding too is very important, because these all important things
happened during Lord Hardington? What was this? Remember, annulment of partition of Bengal. First bomb was thrown at Harding. Transfer of capital from Calcutta to Delhi. The war in Delhi and coronation of George V in 1911. 1912, Bihar and Odisha was separated from Bengal and became a new state, and establishment of Hindu Mahasabha in 1915 by Madan Mohan Malviya, and Gandhiji came back to India from South Africa in 1915. Now next viceroy is Lord Chelmsford. Okay, Lord Chelmsford, this is very much important. Almost all viceroys are important. See, Government of India Act 1919, also known as Montague Chelmsford Reforms, Repressive Rowlatt Act 1991, Jallianwala Bagh Massacre 13 April 1919, Home Rule Movement by Tilak and Inefficient Settler Commission on Education 1917, Appointment of Hunter Commission to look into Jallianwala Bagh Tragedy, Chambers of Prince 1921 was established during this person. Chelmsford, okay. Non-cooperation movement started, Khilafat movement initiated, and Indian Sir Satyendra Prasad Sinha was appointed as the governor of Bengal, and death of Tilak in 1920 also happened during Lord Chelmsford, okay. Now next is Lord Reading. See, remember, this is also important. All viceroys are important. Okay. This Rowlatt Act was repealed along the Press Act of 1910. Holding of simultaneous examination for ICS in England and India from 1923. Prince of Wales visited India in November 1921 during Lord Reading. This is famous line, okay. Prince of Wales visited India in November 1921, and from 1923 this simultaneous examination was held in the ICS in England and India from 1923. Okay, Mopla Rebellion 1921, Kerala, took place in Kerala. Chauri Chaura incident, non-cooperation movement, formation of Swaraj Party by C.R. Das and Motilal Nehru. 1923, Communist Party of India founded by M.N. Roy in 1925. See, Lord Reading, we can't imagine. Means when suddenly question is asked that whose time period or who was the viceroy when the Communist Party of India was founded by M.N. Roy, then we'll get confused, really. I'm totally confused. Okay, so everyone has problem to learn, but we have to memorize all these things. Okay, so Communist Party of India founded by M.N. Roy in 1925, Kakori Train Conspiracy 1925, Bis Party University 1922, Lee Commission 1924 for Public Services, Young Hinton Committee for Currency Notes. So this is important. Currency Notes. Young Hinton Committee was formed for currency notes in 1926, and Lee Commission was formed for public services in 1924. Okay, this Lee Commission for Public Services and Young Hinton Committee for currency notes, remember. And Royal Commission was formed for agriculture, RSS, Rashtriya Swayam Sevak, founded in 1925, and it was founded in Nagpur. Okay, Nagpur, and the month was September. Okay, and murder of Swami Shraddhanand was murdered in 1926. Okay, and this all thing was done during Lord Reading, of course. Now let's come to Lord Irwin. This Lord Irwin, Simon Commission visited in India in 1928, Butler Commission in 1927, the Deepawali Declaration by Lord Irwin in 1929, All India Youth Congress in 1928, Nehru Report 1928, Lahore Session of the Congress 1929, and Pune Swaraj Declaration, First Roundtable Conference 1930, in which Congress severely boycotted. So, First Round Table Conference was boycotted by Congress. Civil Disobedience Movement 1930 started with Dandi March. 12 March 1930, and Gandhi-Irwin Pact 5 March 1931, Sada Act 1929, under which marriageable age of girls 14 years and boys 18 years was raised. Okay, Jawaharlal Nehru and Subhash Chandra Bose founded Independence of India League. So Independence of India League was founded by Jawaharlal Nehru and Subhash Chandra Bose. Jawaharlal Nehru and Subhash Chandra Bose. Okay, this all was during what period? Time period. Lord Irwin. Okay, Lord Irwin. Now let comes to Lord Wellington. Lord Wellington. This Lord Wellington second and third round table conference. Lord Wellington. Okay. A communal award by Macdonald. Government of India Act 1935, Poona Pact was signed. During his period, Orissa was also separated from Bihar 1936, and a new province Sindh was created in 1936. Burma was separated from India as well as in 1935. All India Kisan Sabha in 1936, and foundation of Congress Socialist Party in 1934. Congress Socialist Party in 1934 during Wellington. Lord Linlithgow. He remained the viceroy during the time period 1934 to 44, 10 years, just 10 years. Okay, first general election of Congress ministers occurred during 1936 to 37 during the time period of Lord Linlithgow. Subhash Chandra Bose, president of 51st INC in 1938 at what? Haripura session. This is very important session, Haripura session, 1938. And in this session, S.C. Bose was president. Okay. Forward Bloc was founded by Subhash Chandra Bose in 1939. Deliverance Day by Muslim League in 1939. Lahore Resolution of Muslim League 1940. Demand of Pakistan. This is important. August Offer in 1940. Divide and Quit at the Karachi session 1940, and passing of Quit India Resolution in 1942. This all was during whom time period? That was Lord Linlithgow. Haripura session 1930. Sorry, it should be Tripura session 1939 of Congress. Tripura session occurred during 1939. Tripura 1939. Okay. This Haripura, not this is Tripura. Declared complete independence. Scripps Mission 1942, Quit India Movement 1942. In 1943, Muslim League declared Pakistan Day. Okay. Lord Wavell. CR formula, this is also known as Rajaji formula 1944, Wavell plan and Simla conference 1945, Wavell plan and Simla conference 1945, cabinet mission came to India in May 1946, and the Congress and the Muslim League both rejected the proposal. So cabinet mission proposals in 1946, and it was rejected by both the Congress and Muslim League. Okay, Congress and Muslim League both rejected cabinet mission which came in India in 1946. Muslim League celebrated 16th August 1946 as Direct Action Day. INA Trials and Naval Mutiny of 1946. Now Lord Mountbatten. June 3rd plan came during Lord Mountbatten, last British Viceroy. Last Viceroy was British India. And first Governor General of Free India. Boundary Commission under Radcliffe. Introduction of Indian Independence Bill in the House of Commons. Now the last Governor General of Free India is C. Rajgopalachari, the only Indian Governor General to remain in office from 21st June 1948 to 25th January 1950. Okay. So this last C. Rajgopalachari was the last Governor General of Free India. Okay. And this Governor General and Viceroy topic is completed. And all you have to remember this all things done during whose time period, this all things are to be memorized, and it is really very much difficult. I know that because I too face difficulty in learning all this. So I hope you all will like this video, and thank you so much.